socialism. And the more I look at it, not in isolation, one country, but taking a group of countries that practiced this, the more I become convinced that they were trying to find some indigenous model for economic development. I look at some of the projects they adopted. I cannot see anyone trying to do that today. In 4 to 5 years, Julius Nyerere's government relocated 9 million people, peasants, to different villages as part of Ujamaa. Can you imagine any African president suggesting anything like that today? So the third thing is that I am impressed by the breadth and the boldness of their vision. We find ourselves in serious times. We are told that come 2050, Africa's population will double. We are informed that our mineral resources, the known mineral resources we are exploiting, will be running around 2050. They'll be running out. We are told we need to move from extractive economies to knowledge economies. We are told we'll have a demographic dividend by 2050. We'll have more young adults who work than small dependents and elderly dependents. Depending on your perspective, this is either exciting or it is frightening. But what I do know is that these are serious times, and we need to have that kind of bold vision that this first generation had. Because my economist friends tell me that we need to start growing at double digits if we are to come out well come the middle of the 21st century.